I invite you to stand if you're able to. Did you bring the urn? Okay, no worries. Friends, let us hear these words from Scripture, and may they bring comfort to us at this time. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. God is my light and my salvation. Whom then shall I fear? God is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? And remember that Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. We remember also about how in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth was without form, and there was darkness upon the face of the deep, and the Spirit of God was moving over the face of the waters, and God said, let there be light, and there was light, and God saw that the light was good. Many years after those early days of creation, Jesus the Christ walked this earth before us and said to a group of followers, I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will never walk in darkness, but will indeed have the light of life. And so at this time, when we come in deep sorrow and loss, we light a candle to remind ourselves that the light of God came into the world at creation, was revealed to us in the person of Jesus, and travels throughout all time and space. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness will never, ever overcome it. On behalf of the family, welcome to this time. I know that you are here because you are here to offer your love and support at this time of loss, and we are here together to grieve this loss. And so we gather not because we would choose to be here, but because it is good to be together at times like this. So welcome to you. Your presence is appreciated, and please stay afterwards if you're able for the reception. We gather indeed in the shadow of death to be reminded of the gift of life and its preciousness. We gather to be reminded that in life and in death and in life beyond death, God is indeed with us. We are never alone. The family have chosen some music. We know that that was very important to Jeff. We have three hymns. The first is Morning Has Broken. So I invite you to turn in the red Voices United books in front of you to 409, Morning Has Broken, as we join together in the singing. And we welcome those who are also watching via the live streaming and encourage you to sing along as well.
Thank you.
You may be seated. I invite you to join me in the prayer that is printed in your order of service as we pray together. Let us pray. Holy God, whose ways are not our ways, and whose thoughts are not our thoughts, thank you for your abiding care and grace. Heal hearts made heavy by the loss of Jeff. Through our tears, assure us again that eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor human mind imagined what you have prepared for those who love you. We pray in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. We have several people who will share some memories. We begin with Evan on behalf of our church family.
Church, music, social justice, his work in reinsurance, and of course, skiing and the cottage. These were just some of the things that were very important to Jeff. But through each of them, he forged strong friendships and influenced so many of us. Perhaps he was an influencer before an influencer became a thing. So let me try to tie some of these together. I first met Jeff about 25 years ago when we were attending Tansley United Church, which is now Grace United, and Jeff was actively involved in the board. Now, let me give you a little brief succession or history of the succession at Tansley, because Richard Henson became the chair of the board, then he passed the reins to me, and I, in turn, passed them on to Jeff. Now, by this time, Richard and I had joined the choir, so then, we recruited Jeff to become a member of the bass section with us. See, it was in the job description that you had to be both the board chair and a member of the bass section. But these were two roles in which Jeff excelled. Now, Tansley has a main campus on Walker's Line. That's a strange word, but perhaps more importantly, there is the South Campus. Some of you may know the South Campus better as the judge and jury. So we would have a choir rehearsal on Thursday evenings and then adjourn to the South Campus for a meeting. That is when we really got to know and appreciate Jeff. Jeff would tell us stories about his work in catastrophe modeling in reinsurance. And only Jeff could turn the loss of hundreds of millions of dollars due to a disaster into a funny story. And Jeff would share other things going on in his life, but again, always with some humor. Jeff loved to ski. He had a place in Vermont, but he skied many other mountains, such as Tremblant and Whistler. In fact, he put our family onto Tremblant, and we've been there at least a dozen times since. Now, I mentioned that he was an excellent skier and also a catastrophe modeler, and these two are linked. Okay. I don't know when it was, perhaps 10 years ago, he was in Whistler, and he had mounted a GoPro on his helmet. Now, for those who don't want to know what a GoPro is, it's like a little camera that you mount on the top of your helmet, and it sees exactly, you know, what you're doing while you're skiing. So Jeff decided to go through the glades, or the trees, and where the mountain pitch was very steep. Again, as a catastrophe modeler, you know, he might have recognized that this was not a good idea. Anyway, he tumbled, and when I say tumbled, he had somersaults and rolls, and his skis went flying everywhere, and before he came to a stop. In the skiing vernacular, we call this a yard sale. But in typical Jeff wit, he said, yes, he did get some hurt, or yes, he did get hurt, but he got some great video. So then about a decade ago, the Vannans, the Hensons, Browns, and the McDades transferred to Port Nelson. I think it was Richard that suggested to Jeff that Port Nelson would be a good place for him. Richard convinced him that Port Nelson had a reputation for social justice and for reaching out to the community, but significantly, it had a good music program. So within only a short time, Jeff was active in the choir and had become a presbytery representative, as it was known at that time. So as you can see, themes of church, music, social justice were present throughout all of these years. Now, one of Jeff's strengths was he called them like he saw them. You know, on the board at Tansley, he was decisive, he was convincing, but we didn't always agree, but he was a team player, and he would always support the decisions and directions of the group. On a completely unrelated note, do you ever notice they never wore a jacket in the winter? Anybody notice that? Okay. Now, I think a heavy sweater was just usually sufficient. I guess he claims that growing up in Winnipeg, you know, toughened him up for the Burlington winters that we have here. Yeah. Jeff was a musician, a devoted member of the church, an advocate for social justice, a quick wit, and a friend. Of course, you'll have your own special connection with Jeff, but this was mine. He will be missed.
I have many fond memories of my father growing up that I will cherish. Every weekend in the winters, we'd wake up early and head to the hockey arena. He'd drink his coffee and loudly cheer on the team from the stands. I'm not sure if you know this about my dad, but when he yelled very loud. You could hear him across the arena. Eventually, we both took to skiing. We would head out to the slopes early in the morning while driving and sitting on the chairlifts. We would chat about life and what's new. Going to the cottage was always a special time for the family, swimming, fishing, and boating the days away. I went there last week and I was filled with many happy memories of summer life up north. It's because of my father that I became an accountant. His logical advice helped me realize this career path would provide permanent job security. He always told me if he could do it all over, he'd have been an accountant as well. Even though he wasn't an accountant, he still had a very successful career in the reinsurance business. His success and work ethic set the example for me to strive towards in my career as well. If I have half the success my father had, I'll call that a great career. Thank you, Dad, for the wonderful life you were able to provide. You will be greatly missed.
So, we are all here today to celebrate the life of Jeffrey Vannan, a father, a husband, a brother, and a friend, and I can't believe we're all here today. It's a shock. He was definitely too young. The man just retired a couple years ago, and he had so much life to live with his new wife, Susan. He was deeply loved by many. And you know, I can remember we just went up to the cottage and opened that sucker. And if I had known that was gonna be the last time I'd be with him, I would have convinced him to have a beer or two or seven. I would have twisted his rubber arm. He always had time for people, especially for his family. And he always put himself always put them before himself. I'll tell you a little story about my dad. Years ago when we were growing up and there was a kid on our court and he was sitting out on the curb. It was about 7, 8 in the morning. And we were friends with the family. He was kind of a rambunctious kid. And my dad thought that something might be wrong with this guy, or something was up with him. So he went out and sat on the curb with him for an hour and a half, just to talk with them, to see what was going on. And he went into work late that day. It's the kind of guy that he was. You know, he used to always take us to the comic book store on Saturdays, and then Mr. Sub. And he was just a great guy. And you know what? I will miss him every day of my life. I love you, Dad.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for coming today. My dad was a very hard-working outdoors man, dedicated to understand and teach us many books and Sunday night dinners as a whole family. Loving father he was, as always. Our weekend routines involved our cottage, church, and many karate lessons, dance classes, and hockey practices, to name a few. Following through day after day, aware of his responsibilities, helping with all that is expected of him as a wonderful grandfather. I will truly never get through a day now that he is gone. My dad was my hero in all of the bad. A million little pieces come together as we remember Jeffrey Robert Vannan in all he, as a father, husband, and business partner, was for our family and his friends. Never forgotten as we go on now, taking a piece of him with us forever in our hearts, an eternal light of Christ. We will see you again, Dad. I love you until then.
Be reading from Psalm 42, a song of lament. As a deer longs for flowing streams, so my soul longs for you, O God. My soul thirsts for God, for the living God. When shall I come and behold the face of God? My tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me continually, where is your God? These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I went with a throng and led them in procession to the house of God with glad shouts and songs of thanksgiving, a multitude keeping festival. Why are you cast down, O my soul, and why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God. My soul is cast down within me, therefore I remember you from the land of Jordan and of Hermon and Mount Mizar. Deep calls to deep at the thunder of your cataracts. All your waves and your billows have gone over me. By the day, Lord commands his steadfast love, and at night his song is with me, a prayer to God of my life. I say to God, my rock, why have you forgotten me? Why must I walk about mournfully? Because the enemy oppresses me. As with a deadly wound in my body, my adversaries taunt me, while they say to me continually, where is your God? Why are you cast down, O my soul? And why are you disquieted within me? Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God.
Thank you.
In the midst of a long speech, sermon in Matthew, Jesus is teaching the disciples and all who would listen about life in him and life in God. And we come to these words that have comforted hearts and reassured spirits for generations. Come to me, all you who are weary and who are carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy, and my burden is light. Thanks be to God. Amen. These things I remember as I pour out my soul, how I was part of the wedding procession just a few short weeks ago here in the house of God with songs of thanksgiving for the joy shared in marriage. But now my soul is cast down in me. Lately my tears have been my food day and night, while people say to me continually, "Where is your God?" My soul is cast down within me. I remember former times of happiness. I know deep down that day and night God commands his love for me. But these days I say to God, my rock, "Why have you forgotten me? Why are you cast down, O my soul?" The music of faith is captured most deeply and most expressively in the Psalms. The Hebrew songs are the church's first hymn book. They were known to Jesus himself and formed an integral part of Jewish temple worship. And they express the vast diversity of human emotion and experience. Today, we turn to the faith story in our time of grief and loss. And as we do so, we find that one third of the Psalms are laments. These are the cries of those who have experienced loss of various sort. And the writer of Psalm 42 expresses how things used to be so much better, but now he is left with the questions. Where is God? Why have you forgotten me? And why are you cast down, O my soul? The psalmist asks these questions not because there are easy answers that someone will give him, but because they are on the mind and in the heart. And it's always best to express what's on the mind and in the heart. That's why it's important for us today to express our lament. It is important to express what we are collectively and individually experiencing and bringing to this space and this hour, because it is the reality that we are living. Jeff has died unexpectedly and suddenly. He had been married to Susan for just 7 weeks. He had lost his first wife, Vicky, 5 years ago. Jennifer, Christopher and Joshua now carry on their journeys without both parents. Susan regroups yet again, having lost 3 husbands in 12 years. Jeff's extended family and friends, and we as a church family, must come to grips with this situation. Jeff is the 4th member of our church choir to die in the last year. So there is much to lament today, and as minister here, it is my job to help us to be intentional about not rushing through that. While we give thanks for Jeff's life, this is by no means a full-throated celebration. Indeed, it would be a mistake to call it that. I think that we take our lead from the Psalms, one-third of them being lament. Now, Jeff and Susan met as part of the choir here at Port Nelson. It was their love of music and the community of musicians that are before us today that drew them together. And over the course of a year, the choir sings laments and praises. The choir sings songs of trust and thanksgiving. The choir and all of us sing of healing and of longing. We mirror the diversity that is God's song and the expression of a complete and mature faith. And in the time that I knew Jeff, since he joined our church, I experienced Jeff as mirroring a mature faith. Church was very important to Jeff. If he was in town, he was here. We don't have a South Campus, so it all happens here, including the drinking. Several years ago, I remember we did a series on the four values of our congregation, and we asked four different people to speak on one of the values during a service. Jeff spoke about the importance of worship and of music. And I still remember it was beyond anything I could have ever imagined, the depth and the passion with which he shared the importance of his own faith journey and how it has been nurtured across the decades with the community and particularly the gift of music. He was so well prepared. Did Jeff ever do anything for which he was not meticulously prepared? I don't think so. I'm told over here by neighbors who lived at Central Park Village that the condo board never ran so smoothly as it did when Jeff chaired it. It's just how he did things: organized, strategic, thoughtful, able to look at the bigger picture. So many gifts. And this is why our lament today is so heartfelt and deep. Because we feel the loss of all that Jeff was and all he did and all whom he touched. There are no easy answers as to why death in its cruelty has taken this away from us. Just like thousands of years ago, there were no answers when the psalmist cried out the lament. But what we do know is that nearly every time, the lament ends with what is called the vow to praise. We heard it in Psalm 42 that Louise read. Amid the tough questions the psalmist asks, "Where is your God? Why have you forgotten me? Why are you cast down, O my soul?" He is able to say amid that, "Hope in God, for I shall again praise him, my help and my God." It is a comment in the future tense, "I shall again praise." Because we may not feel like praising much today, and that is okay. In fact, I think it is to be expected. We're still lamenting. But the good news and the hope is that one day we will again praise, because there is much for which to give thanks for the life of Jeff, who he was, what he valued and shared and taught, how he lived, and what we will not forget. Hope in God so that again someday we may praise. In the meantime, the psalmist again reaches down into our hearts with words that have comforted countless. "The Lord is my shepherd, I have everything I need. because God walks alongside us amid the pastures and the still waters, restoring us, healing us, reminding us that we are never alone. It is my hope and my prayer, particularly for members of the families, that each person here today, wherever you may find yourself on this journey ahead, might in the midst of the lament find the hope and the peace that only God can bring at times like this. For we are not alone. We live in God's world and in God's word, in life and in death, and in life beyond death, God is with us. Thanks be.
Let us pray. Eternal God, source of life beyond knowledge and thought, mysterious and profound, we have seen you in Jeff, who has died. For your love in him, all its achievements, all its struggles, and for your love and received our life, family and friends. Give thanks to you, God, his love for his family and friends, his gift of song, his contribution to the life and work of church, his joy in skiing, his advocacy for social justice. And now, in a few moments of silence, we bring our own special memories and thanksgivings before you. And in a few moments of silence, we bring the memories of this faith community before you. Lord, it is because of our good and varied memories that our sorrow is real and our loss is great. We bring before you all who will miss Jeff so much, and we ask you to surround them with love, give them the strength they need to bear their grief, hold them close. In time, may you bless them with healing and nourish their souls with good memories. Lord, be with Susan Collett, Jeff's wife, his daughter Jennifer, his sons Christopher and Joshua, his grandchildren Austin, Alex, Aidan, Noah, Sophia, Charlotte, Violet, and Brodie, his brother Harley and sister-in-law Gloria, his sister Lisa and brother-in-law Bill, his brother Mark and sister-in-law Beatrix, and his sister Gillian. Lord, be with them all and help them to bear their grief. Give them hope. Give them peace. Let us pray together the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Thank you.
As I mentioned at the outset, please stay after if you're able for the reception, an opportunity to greet the family if you have not done so already, to take a look at the pictures of Jeff, which appear on the monitor just outside the doors on your way out. And if you wish to make a memorial contribution to this church family, there is information just outside the doors, or you can visit our website. That would be greatly appreciated by us and by the family. Please join me as we share in the words of commendation and blessing as we commend Jeff on the final leg of his journey home. You only are immortal, O God, creator of us all. We are mortal, formed of the earth, and to the earth we shall return. This you ordained when you created us, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us return to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. And so we pray now that you would give rest, O Christ, to your servant, Jeffrey Vannan, with all your saints, where there is neither pain nor sorrow nor sighing, but life everlasting. Into your hands, O merciful one, we commend your servant, Jeff. Acknowledge, we humbly pray, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, and a son of your own redeeming. We pray that you would receive him into the arms of mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of all the saints in light. Amen. Now may the blessing of God, whose love created all things and gave us life, be with you this day. Thanks be to God. May the blessing of Jesus Christ, who defeated death by rising at Easter, be with you always.
Thanks be to God.
And may the blessing of the Holy Spirit, whose presence comforts us and enables us to comfort one another, be with you always.
Thanks be to God.
Go now in God's peace.
Thank you.